Hey, welcome back everybody to another episode of Clouds of Darkness. So the last four episodes were all parts of that dungeon expedition, and I've got some good feedback about it, but most people definitely said that it was too long, and it was hard for me to edit something together like this for the first time. But I learned a lot from it, so the next times we go into one of these other islands where there's more to explore, I will work on to compact it to at least two episodes down, max. One is gonna be really hard, but two should be doable. And if it's one, it might be a longer one. But anyway, so let's get started today. I want to make a mob farm. It's been on our to-do list for a long time, and we're gonna do this today. And I did a lot of testing in single player. Mob farms are very, very dangerous. I tried the grinder setup with mob essences and so on, but that had just as much danger with all the Endermen, Ender Minis, Ender Creepers. Ooh, warp effect that I have no idea. I haven't even started with Thaumcraft, but I'm getting warp effects. Isn't that lovely? And then there's also, I had ghost spiders come through the wall and stuff like that. So I came up with a design that is absolutely nuts, the security on it. But in order to build this, because it's very dangerous to build today, we are going to fly. And just a quick update, I took all these seeds from underneath the harvester that we got from all the grass that was spreading. And I planted all kinds of stuff over here. We have so much food, it's insane. And killed the cows a few times. Got lots of leather and beef. And over here is a bunch of naked sheep. I added an adjustable chest here with an energy upgrade and the animal upgrade. And what that does is, if there was milk buckets inside, it would milk cows. But I really don't care right now. I might actually add that over there and then put 10 buckets in it, so we always have 10 buckets ready. But this one is just shearing sheep. Hey, since when do I have a white one? I didn't know I had a white one. Well, apparently I do. And see, it was just sheared, and it goes in here. It's an amazing mod. And so yeah, that's it. Otherwise, down here has nothing has changed. We're still doing the iron crops, wheat, and rubber trees. All right, warp effect, take it easy. And I've been cooking up bunch of plastic because we're gonna need a lot of rednet cables. And if I'm not mistaken, this still should be the regular recipe. Yes, okay. All right, so, but now the bad news. And I'm really upset about this. And I have not gotten an answer yet in the official Clouds of Darkness forum thread as to why this is, but it makes no friggin' sense to me. For some reason, I wanted to test what actually happens if we die. So I made a backup of the world, got in, and jumped over into the void. The world got deleted. We're not coming back as the clone. Then I did further testing. I put one of these shell storages over here. And then when you use your bed, apparently, yeah, that's what it did. And right-click, it makes it your default storage or something. It didn't do anything for me, and then I shift right-clicked it, so I went into that storage and then came out as the clone. Again, jumped in the void, world got deleted. So, this is useless. The entire mod is useless. I have no idea why it's in here because, well, there is nothing else in this mod that does anything. This treadmill is just so you can make power to power this. You can apparently like put a pig on it, and when it walks, it makes power. So I have no idea what's going on. If you guys have any suggestions, if they're doing something wrong, I can't figure it out. We clearly have a clone, but it's just for show. It doesn't do anything. Anyways, we gotta be careful and moving on. So today I wanna fly, and I set up an electrolytic separator on top of an aqueous accumulator and put a gas tank next to it because this internal storage is very low. I think it's 5 buckets. And this gas tank has been filling now for a while, because in order to fill a jetpack, you need a lot of a lot of this gas, and I didn't want to have to wait for it. And so this is just running, and we are still doing good on power. And I think that's because these conduits are probably the bottleneck or something. But we're doing fine. And I also added a crusher because I needed to crush diamonds down to diamond dust. And that is for our jetpack. I also made a 32 steel between with the mechanism way where you use 2 coal per iron to make a steel dust. You have to put it through twice. What is it called again? Just to show you guys this thing right here. When you send it through once with coal and an iron, you get this enriched alloy, and then you send it through again with a coal, and then you get the steel dust. Anyway, let's take out this jetpack, and of course, I want to make sure that we have at least some protection from it, so I'm making the armored jetpack out of it. I don't think it has anything like the diamond chestplate, but it's still good armor, better than nothing. And yeah, that's it. So now we go ahead and put this in here, and I'm gonna wait for it to charge up, and then when it's full, we'll test it out. And we might take a look over at this island real quick. I wanna see what's on there if it's this close. And I should probably. Let's make a glider real quick, because that's gonna be faster to get over there. Because that way we can, you know, just fly up. Because the jetpack itself, if you just fly with it, it's actually, you know, it's not fast. The main purpose of this jetpack is though, so it saves my life when I build this mob tower, because that's gonna be a little bit dangerous. I can just leave this here. How full is this? Almost full. Okay, I'll be right back once it's full. Okay, I just had a sleepy because I wanted to make sure it's morning. The one we fly over there. All right, let's see. Okay, cool. Let's head over. Oh, only a slime island. I was hoping for something exciting, but let's see, maybe there's a surprise for us over here. I don't know if there's anything useful here for us. I don't know what you. Is there any use for this? Besides bouncing? Ooh, I gotta be careful with fall damage. I should probably make these other boots now. Hey, you said just any use for this? We can make the slime channels, meh. That's like a vanilla water, but it doesn't spread, so you can still make water channels and stuff. Oh well, I don't need this right now. We'll just leave it here. And let's take a look underneath the island so there's nothing. That would be awesome if there's something down here. What? An ore berry bush. Aluminum. I don't care about aluminum. Well, if there is a carpenter safe down here, it could be any one of these blocks. If you guys know if there's something hidden down here or on these on this island, let me know and I'll come back. Which way are we going? Should have probably paid attention. Okay, that way. So let's fly back, and I actually wanted to take a look underneath the island real quick. Zoom. See what's going on down here, that there's something else hidden. And we can take a look from underneath. That's always cool. There's some carpenter block down there. I can't see anything. Nope, don't see anything. Oh, too bad. But this is gonna make all the difference in the world now for building, let me tell you guys. This is gonna make my life a lot easier now with the jetpack. Cool, and we can take an overlook. Anyway, so mob farm. There's a couple of goals that I have for the mob farm, and that is A, make it very, very safe. And in order for that to be possible, we need to make sure that nothing can teleport to our island. And there's only one way that I can really n figure out on how to do that, and that is use a lot of water. And the other thing is, I want it to be able to turn it off and on via lighting. It's going to be a passive mob farm with an AFK room that is hopefully going to be safe, but I have an idea for that also. And if there's any stragglers that get out, that I don't want them to have a way to walk over here and a way to automatically kill them when I want to go in. Now that is a lot of objectives for a mob farm, but well, this mod pack is unforgiving. We cannot afford a death, so it's just got to be very safe. And I figured we're gonna build it out from here, this way. Now the thing is that when I built this out here this way, we cannot come out with any parts over here or over here that way. So that means the rest of the base needs to be, here, this way, that way, and so on in the other directions once we build it. And I think that's okay. We got a lot of room here. Eventually, I'm going to, make this nice, make this an actual house or something, not just have everything out in the open. But we just have too much to do to worry about this just yet. So what I'm gonna do is get started here, and it's gonna take way too long to set this all up on camera. So I'm gonna cut in and out a lot and show you guys all the important parts. And now the other thing is, I want to make sure real quick, I'm gonna make a pair of these free runners so I cannot take any fall damage, and take off these boots. I think the free runners give you armor like iron armor. So we're gonna go ahead. I'm gonna go ahead and make this now off camera, and then tune in once I have the first layout of the mob farm done and show you guys more in details. Already had to charge my jetpack once because I've been using hover mostly. Let me show you guys now the footprint. This is the bottommost layer that this mob trap is gonna have, or mob farm, I should say. And this is gonna be a walkway to get to the actual spawn tower. And I made it a little round up front. This is gonna be all encased. So I can place water on the walkway and also on top of this lower building or whatever you want to call this then. And this is where we're gonna have probably a few barrels and stuff for the majority of the drops, and I'm not sure yet exactly. And also an AFK room somewhere here off the side, or like right here. How exactly, I'm not sure yet, but I just wanted to give you guys a quick update. And this is gonna be the tower up here, the fall tower. And it's not gonna be a mob farm that is dependent on fall damage, because in testing, I found out there's a lot of armored mobs and mobs with insane health pools, especially if you get these. I think they're called infernal mobs. So we're gonna have iron spikes down here that are gonna finish the job. And yep, I'm gonna go ahead and build the tower now, and then I'll show you guys what that looks like. Okay, so this is what it looks so far. The top is still open because I want to make sure I'll add the lights first before I close it. So I pretty much don't need to go on the inside anymore. And I forgot to bring some more water. Let me get a few buckets. So I only need to do two trips. And you guys see this right here, the particle customizer none. I was kind of hoping that I can put that on the jetpack, but I didn't read properly. It's from the simple jetpacks mod and not from mechanism. Speaking of jetpacks, I should probably take this guy with me. All right, so let's get up there, and we're gonna go ahead and lay the first redstone lamps so we can disable this. You guys see I have glowstone nooks everywhere because I was working through the night, and I wanted to make sure that, we don't have any surprises. So we're gonna put one there, and I think that should be enough to light up the whole area. And I'll explain to you just real quick, in case you guys have never seen one of these drop towers before, how that works is these areas right here. I'm gonna take these off, they're gonna go away. Is where the mobs spawn, and it's gonna be three tall, so we also can have Enderman spawn. And then we just going to hope for them to be stubborn enough to want to go after me, run to these channels, fall down, and then they can get back up and they get pushed down via water into this drop chamber. And go ahead and show you guys. Now, these are exactly 8 long, so the water ends right here in the end. And the mobs all fall down, and that is it. All right, I placed the rest of the water in a minute, but I wanted to show you guys. So where's the front? So we want to bring all the cables over to. Going to actually have a second layer on top here. So these cables are actually going to be visible from the bottom, but so we can make sure there's no lighting to come through, I'm gonna place another layer on top, and that's where we're gonna have our water. So the Enderman and so on, they cannot spawn to the top. I mean teleport to the top. I made a bunch of these RedNet cables because we're gonna run them all the way up to over here. The stuff that we're gonna build downstairs, plus the light up here, everything is gonna be manageable from over here. So we can make sure to, you know, disable it and so on before we even come here. Let's just put a lever on here. What am I thinking? Yeah, that doesn't work. Okay, here we go. And here we go. All right, so now all four are on. And now when I press F7, and let's see if that is enough real quick. Take off these lights. This one. One. And I just stuck with cobblestone. I kind of gave it a, you know, different look. But the thing is, we won't be able to see any of this later on when it's done. You'll guys see. It's kind of hard to explain all the security features that I'm putting in here. So far, so good. Do I have F7 on? No. So these lights are not enough. Okay, so we gotta add one in between here and more on the side. All right, I'm just gonna put the lights back because, well, I don't want any surprises. Did that reach up there? No. Because mobs here, they spawn so incredibly fast. They spawn right next to you. They don't care. There's no, you know, 25 block rule like in vanilla. I'm just putting these lights back. I'm gonna get more redstone lamps and bring them back up here, and then I can show you how everything is lit up. I get a little tired of messing around with trying to minimize the amount of redstone lamps, so I just put four per platform. I tried two diagonally like this, but then I still had dark corners here and there. I'm like, ah, what the heck? Let's just make more redstone lamps and put it there so we can make sure it's safe. You guys also see I placed the signs all the way around here. Now, people use trapdoors or signs. I like the signs better because trapdoors, in case we want to have some kind of a water contraption on top that, you know, maybe cleans out platforms if it's needed or something. When the water touches these trapdoors, they change state. So then you need to come in and close them all again, open them all again so mobs can fall. So I just think signs are better. And in case you guys don't know what they do is the mobs don't know that this is a block they can stand on. So if they're standing right there, they think they can walk across and they step on here and boom, fall down. And I'm hoping to speed up the process that these mobs up here, maybe, you know, don't just stand around. It's been quite fast in testing that I've done. And, you know, I've built many of these farms, just never with all the other gobbledygook that we're gonna build on top and this walkway. Where is it? Over there. So anyway, hey, and by the way, make sure you don't shift click when you make signs so you don't have a million left over, but it's only wood. So there's no spawning areas right now. Let's turn off the light and look at this. Instantly everything is yellow And gonna make sure to turn it on because the moon is coming up, so we don't want to have any mobs here. Actually, you know what? We're quite safe up here. Let's see if we can get one or two mobs to spawn here. They usually spawn very fast, even when I'm around. And of course, when I'm recording, they aren't. Come on. No, no luck. I can't see anything anymore, so I'm turning on the light. It got too dark. I got scared. All right, so what I'm going to do now is fill in all this right here with... Oh, I got to take plain cobble because you see how these connect. And I just don't want to have this connected. So in the inside of it, I'm going to just use plain cobble to show you guys what I mean. I still have plain cobble. Okay. When you put the plain cobble like this, you see it does not connect. I don't think it's going to do anything that causes a problem, but I just don't like these redstone cables connecting to stuff that I don't actually want to talk to. And again, this middle layer is usually the end of the mob farm. It's three high here, but I want to put another layer on top, so the light cannot go through these blocks right here, because if it's daytime, then the light will shine through and it's going to lower our spawn rate probably to zero. But I'm not going to put the last layer until everything else is done, because I got to wait for day for sure. It's because once I put the last layer on here, I got to fill it instantly with water, and you'll guys see that shortly. So I'm going to go ahead and tune back in when we're at the next stage. Okay guys, I'm a little frustrated because I can't figure out how to make these iron spikes. You guys can tell there's a recipe change that they put in the mod pack. You need a carpenter's prism slope and carpenter's prism wedge slopes, and I cannot figure out how to make them. For the life of me. I've been playing with this, I think, for half an hour now. So you can make these carpenter wedge slopes, and when you right-click them, you change them around to all these different shapes, and there is that looks like the prism slope to me. But I don't know how to pick it up. I tried the pick, I tried the axe, I tried everything trying to pick this thing up, but as soon as you do, you get this item back here. And when you put it into the crafting grid, there's nothing you can do with it either. I don't know. I looked online if there's a recipe for it, but there isn't. I just cannot figure out how to do anything with these. If you guys have any ideas that are missing something, please let me know down in the comments. But I found a different solution in the meantime. And that's these spikes from Minecraft Rediscovered mod. And the way you make this is with iron bars in the chisel. And then you can make these menacing iron spikes, pull them out, and then just pressure plates to make them. I hope they're going to work. I'm going to step on it real quick so you guys can see. Boop, instantly start taking damage. So they should work just like the iron spikes, and we're going to go ahead and set those up over here in a moment. Okay, so I ran the RedNet cable all the way down here into our little control room. That's where it's going to be. I decided not to put it up here because I kind of want to have the controls of where I'm going to have my AFK room right here. And I'm going to use obsidian and some glass so I can look out later. And I just, you know, make it feel really safe. I'm probably even going to change the floor to obsidian. Just, you never know what happens. You guys remember in that dungeon, there were some creepers that were able to destroy blocks. And I just don't want to risk it. So, now, this is where I played around with a lot. And I came up with this design here with a double piston on each side. And what this is going to do is we're going to have two blocks here. And then we're going to have, and hopefully this works with these, the iron spikes worked. We're going to have our spikes like this. Now I changed these. The top ones are red-red and the bottom are green-green. And the same on this side. So, and now over here I have the controls. The lights are on already up here. Lights, spikes, and floor. The lights are turned on. I double checked it works. And now we can close the floor Oops, no, we can't because I gotta change the colors over here. I wanted to show you guys this from this angle. So I said the floor is green. Let me get to that color. There we go. And the spikes are the red line. And just to give an idea why I always disconnect the cables, like on these blocks, on all these chiseled ones, how much hydrogen do I have? Okay, 7,000, that's enough. I show you guys underneath real quick. If I, right here, this piston right there, if I don't disconnect this, because by default, there, this is how it's by default. Whenever it touches one of these chisels, they want to connect. And every one of them is default white. So I would have to change this now to another color. So I always just go around whenever I lay these cables and disconnect it from everything that I needed. So this piston now doesn't do anything until it actually gets the green signal. Alright, let's do this now. So now when I turn on the floor, it is closed. And that's where it's going to be most of the time, even when the spikes are out. Just so there's another floor underneath and we can't lose any drops or whatever. But if I ever need to, there's some problem or whatever, okay, I can then turn off, open the floor, and whatever spawns up there, when they fall down, they just fall down into the void. This is just little thing. We might not use it very often, but I wanted to make sure that we have it just in case. And now, hopefully, these spikes also work. No. This is red, and this is red. So these spikes cannot be pushed. Oh. Okay. Well, this royally sucks. Let me just double check. This is red, and these are red. And I guess I can just do a test here real quick, just to make sure it's not the connection. Put the lever right there. No. Ah, this sucks because with the iron spikes you can move them, but apparently you cannot move these. Let me take this off and just see if it can maybe be pulled back. No. Alright. Well, that means we're gonna flip-flop this. And meaning that we're gonna put the blocks on top. So we unfortunately cannot do what I had planned. And oh, I lost the piston. No, it's right there. But I lost the other one, didn't I? Well, that's just perfect. All right, I'm gonna be back. Hi guys, I'm in a test world here because I wanted to test these spikes, how they react to mob drops, what's gonna happen to them. And these are the iron spike that I wanted to make initially, but I can't figure out how to craft those carpenter's blocks for it. And when you throw items at it, they stay there just the way it's supposed to be. And these spikes right here, they destroy the blocks. So we cannot use them for our kill chamber. They're absolutely useless. Alright guys, so if the iron spikes are not craftable and the other ones eat our drops, then I guess we just have to go with a grinder because we cannot count on them to die from the drop damage and then just suck it up, because like I explained earlier, a lot of these mobs have armor or insane amount of health. So, and the only thing I'm worried now is because this is a 25 block drop, that a lot of mobs are gonna die by impact. And well, we'll see if we'd like put an item collector next to it if we get the drops. I'm not sure, but a lot of mobs are gonna survive and we'll keep our eye on it. I encased this in obsidian just to keep the scheme here from this. Of course without the pillar, because I want to keep the back open for the chest, and we're probably gonna take the liquid out this way or something. We'll see. And I still had two windmills, actually, or wind turbines. And I figured we're gonna put them all the way up here instead of having them down there, because there's gonna be a lot of water here and they need a view to the sky. So these guys are making us a lot of power, enough for that one grinder. And I put them one higher because that's gonna be the regular wall and a gap in between, so hopefully water can run in there so mobs cannot even teleport to this one little block. But we'll see. So now the AFK chamber, I also have in case an obsidian that glowstone look is gonna go away later because also this is gonna be flooded with water. And oh, because I'm hovering, there we go. And when we go in, we got the console here. When everything is going, all levers are down. It means when everything is off, I'm sorry. Lights are on, grinder is off, and the floor is closed. So right now, this is like maintenance mode. I can fall to my death if I go in here and so on because the floor is closed and I broke this one. All right, so, and if we're having issues or something out in the because the lights don't work or anything, we can open the floor so everything just falls to their death. And otherwise, it's gonna be off, on. So now, well, I don't want to turn this on just yet. The lights, I mean, because I want to make sure we don't got anything teleporting. But now the grinder's ticking. Now all we gotta do is set up an inventory, and I'm just gonna go with a chest for right now and then let this run to figure out all the drops that we're getting. Most importantly, we want ender pearls. But before we can do this, I need to now enclose this walkway around it. And we got a blood moon rising, beautiful, so I can sleep. And I need to enclose this entire walkway. And then when it's done, then I'm gonna show you guys what the deal is with all the water. And yeah, and then we should be able to turn this on and see if we still have anything port into this AFK room or whatever potentially, but we'll work on that when we get to that point. You guys can see we're about noon now, and I finished the ceilings of the walkway and also the inside of this kill area. And there's a lot of red X's and yellow X's, so what I want to make now is place all this water as fast as I can. So when nighttime comes, nothing can spawn up here. It was pretty hairy because the last night cycle was a blood moon, so I couldn't sleep. And then I started building this already, and I actually had a spider spawn up here, but it just jumped to its death, so it was okay. So I'm gonna place water all along this walkway, and then when I got that done, I filled the water over there on the platform. And then I'll show you guys the inside, and then we can place the water all the way up there. And then we should be good to go. So we're almost done. So now I got all the water placed, and this is just the safest way that I could think of. And look at all the squid. The safest way on how to keep everything that spawns up in here that can teleport to getting to our base. We'll go inside in a minute, but I really want to finish the top now that it's noon. That should be quite quick. The water up here is going to be a lot easier to place. So what I'm going to do now is just place all the cobblestone up here, another layer. And this, of course, is going to connect down here now. Oh boy, but that shouldn't matter because it's the default color for the lights. So if I don't want them to be on, then they won't get a signal, the white signal. So that should not make any difference. It's pretty much impossible now without going back down and breaking all the cobble to stop these cables from connecting. Okay, I'll place all the cobble up here and place the water, and then I'll meet you guys downstairs. Are you guys ready to turn this on? It's a lot of water, huh? I think it looks awesome. And the tunnel in here, I made it, 2.5 blocks tall, so it's I don't want to make it, only too tall. It's getting like a claustrophobic almost, but kind of a cool effect here. And nothing changed in the control room here. All still the same, lights are still on. The floor is closed. The grinder is actually on. Right? Yes, it is. Okay. And we got this drum in the dungeon, and I hooked up the fluid pipe to go in here. And I put in a adjustable chest with the seven upgrades over here. I put these slabs because there's the pistons and the cables underneath. And I say we turn this on and see what happens. I got my sword out. Okay, lights are off. Good to go. Let's risk it. Boarded hand. Because there might be a few Ender Minis or something coming out. Let's see when we're getting the first mobs to come down here. Alright, they're all dying on impact. Not this guy. Okay, I definitely have to figure out. Maybe I'll put another block in here so it's 24 and see if that works. But we're getting drops already. Cool. And a little bit of essence. What a terrible sound. Alright, I'm gonna turn the lights on again. And I'm gonna go ahead and see if adding a block in here is gonna make a difference once they're dead. I think we got a leak. Somebody call a plumber. Well, I flooded this room here to make sure these Enderminis don't teleport around. I've had them running around everywhere like crazy and I found it annoying. So I just flooded this room. And then I was also thinking, like, why do I care that these guys die on impact? That's what we wanted to have in the beginning. So I made this advanced item collector and put it on top of the chest and set the radius, you know, just high. So it picks up everything around here. And when mobs die to fall damage, this guy sucks up the loot. And if they survive, then the grinder will kick in and kill them. We already have 113 buckets of mob essence. This has been running 15, 20 minutes tops. And look at the amount of stuff we already have. Already over a stack of ender pearls, which I'm really happy about. And the rotten flesh, so we can start making fertilized dirt to start sifting that. And so on. After the episode, I'm gonna try to figure out how I'm going to sort all this and store it. I would... What? Where are you teleporting? Into this little room? Oh yeah, one more change in here. I put slabs on the ceiling because this was three high and when I was standing in, I'm like, hey, wait, an Enderman could possibly teleport in here. I'll put the slabs up here, so now I think we're safe. Anyway, I'm gonna let this run and then figure out how we're gonna handle all these mob drops. I would really like to get them back over here somewhere and then do the sorting over here. But that's a long way and I don't know. Maybe we use transfer nodes, but that is a long way. That means I would need quite a lot of speed upgrades and I don't have any more blaze rods for ender chests. Let's see. Oh, they also take ender infused. Well, we could make these. They're actually not out of reach now. I'll gotta figure out if we're gonna do this, but if I look into the quest book, first of all, a viewer replied, and I'm really happy that he did, or she, that this is already completed. We needed 5 kills for the first one, and then that viewer said, you know, just click on claim rewards, and then it goes to the next one, and I did not know that. So, I guess we're getting all this stuff here now, so let's go ahead and do that. Yep, that's awesome. I wonder if, you know, we just get this every time. So now if we can till more next time, when we go to a dungeon or something, then we're gonna get this. But, about the Nether. There is, let me see right here, this quest, the Nether. It says, you know, oh, wait a second. I didn't see that. Apparently, did I turn this in already? Oh, we gotta do now to the next one, yes. Well, we need 20 cobalt and 20 ardite. But in the official forum post, it says, you know, don't make your own portals. There is one everywhere in the places that you need to go to. And we have, let's see here, Fortress of Hell. I'm gonna guess that has something to do with the Nether, so I think next episode we're gonna go there and check it out and then see if we can find the Nether portal. And I'm hoping that there's also some blazes. We got fire resist pots now, so we'll head over there next time. But now, to end the episode, we just got these gift boxes. We are going to go use our little chamber down here. And that is just gift boxes. I don't know if these are special ones, but we take the sword out, and I'm gonna put the rapier in here from now on because that way this sword levels also. I don't want to put these in here just in case something goes wrong. I don't want to lose them. So we're gonna set this to right click. And come on, we put one in there. And turn it on. It looks like we got a ton of chickens and a diamond. Well, I'm a hope that these guys are killable. Holy moly, that's a lot of chickens. Did I get them all? No runners? All right. Nine diamonds, nice. All right. Let's put the next one in here. I heard it get placed. Whoa. Two of them. Well, we're gonna need a lot more to make an end portal. Not that we could go there because we probably get killed so fast. That one is placed. What, nothing? Or is this a trap? It did get placed, right? Okay. Maybe some gift boxes don't have anything. Who knows? What? What was that noise? Oh, God. Oh, did it break upstairs? No. I wonder what it built up there. My pig. I'm just gonna close this off so I have nothing else, and I'll bring the pig back up here. Oh, we got more enough. We got more pigs up here. I'm just gonna kill it. Get out of here, eggs. All right, and we got one more, so let's open that one. I wonder what that sound was. Sounded like glass breaking. Thank you for the bacon. And the last one. God, what is this? No, he looks mean. He gonna die. I'm not risking that. Sorry, buddy. One hit. Wow. Well, I did not know that it only takes one hit. I'm gonna leave this stuff in here. I'm gonna take him with me. Thank you for the wheat. Okay. Cool. Well, we got a very safe mob farm, which was my goal. I know it's not pretty, you know, having this huge water tower monster here, but nothing can teleport over here, and we can AFK in there very nicely. So I think I'm calling this a success, even though the iron spikes didn't work out, the other spikes didn't work out. Look at that sword. Doesn't it look awesome? Oh my God. And yeah, but we gotta go now, and definitely, I'm really happy about all the mob drops that we're getting, especially the rotten flesh and the ender pearls. And yeah, next time we'll go overhead into the Nether Fortress, and between episodes, I'm gonna figure out how I'm going to handle all these mob drops. And you know, keep sifting, keep putting stuff away in the barrels, and so on. So we have a lot of materials, and so we can continue nicely in the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode, and if you did, I'll appreciate a thumbs up like always. And until next time, take care, everybody. Bye-bye.